there's Lee Daniels and Danny Strong who create the show, and there's, you know, there's a lot of very strong voices, you know, and I enjoy that. I enjoy all that back and forth with really strong creative people,
yes,
who are smart and, you know, who sort of came up with the show in the first place and come up with a lot of great ideas. So it's great for me as a composer to be able to knock ideas back and forth with them, and, you know, hopefully the result's all the better for it.
We want to tell the truth, whether it's good or bad. That's what the show is about.
What's great is that African Americans are not just in front of the camera, but we are behind the camera. We are creators, we are writers. To be able to employ a bunch of directors of color, at Debbie Allen, John Singleton, Anthony Hemingway, Mary Van Peebles. These are people that I look up to and that I admire, and I'm just so happy that we're all working together.
I just love seeing programs that have people of color in them. You know, I think we need more of that. I think that Hollywood needs to continue to be open-minded. And, you know, I just think that more stories about our lives just need to be told all across the board, no matter how it's told. You know what I mean?
A lot of work that has to be put in, you know, and it's all kind of like showing, it's here now, you know, and it's paying off, and it's making us happy and kind of giving us more motivation to keep going and putting out more stuff and just giving the world, you know, what they want.
I started selling drugs when I was 9 years old. I did it to feed myself. But it was music that played through my mind that kept me alive when I thought I was gonna get shot. And it was the lyrics that I dreamt about that kept me warm while I was sleeping in the streets. Music saved my life.
My character, Tiana Brown, she's edgy, and I wanted to bring a little bit of that as well as myself. She's a little bit more racy than I am. I wish I could be like her sometimes.
Anika Calhoun is the head of A&R for Empire. She also happens to be the girlfriend of Lucius Lyon. But she's so much more than just that. She's so much more than just a love interest. She's excellent at what she does. She's tenacious. She's indomitable. She is vulnerable. She's strong. She's powerful. And just like everybody, she wants exactly what she feels like she deserves because she wants to be validated as a person.
I would be scared of Rhonda. No, it's so funny, like when I get dressed like this every day, Rita, our wonderful costume designer, is like, it is just so funny that you play Rhonda, because you're like obsessed with animals and a tree hugger and love everybody and you're so sweet, and you get on screen and you're like, oh no.
Yes.
You know, like that. But no, I hope I'm not much like Rhonda. I don't want to be like manipulative and, you know, whatever, controlling, and she uses her sexuality a lot. Honestly, I'm not that kind of person. I'm kind of prude, and I'm not a big flirty. I'm like an awkward flirter, I think. So, yeah, I've had to replay in my mind my friends that I think are sexy. I'm like, okay, what would Sarah do? Or what, you know what I mean? Like, and just be like, okay, I can do this, for sure. Yeah.
Is there anything that you can tell us about what's going to happen in this show?
Well,
pertaining to your character, at least.
Okay. Well, I can't say, but she gets introduced, and she's confident. She's gonna go there, you know, and you'll have to watch and see.
My two sons, both are releasing new albums.
I need you to sing like you're gonna die tomorrow. Like this is the last song you will ever sing.
To the Empire.